Start from the topic we have left in the previous class, that is magic tea. So we were discussing on E-plane tea and H-plane tea in the following lecture, and then now we have come across magic tea. So magic tea is called as the combination of E and H-plane tea, as well as we have also seen that magic tea can have both summation as well as subtraction, both the process, because it is combination of EH-plane tea. And it is also called as a hybrid tea. So we have all drawn this diagram of magic tea, and you have completed this diagram in the previous class. Now we are going to discuss about the characteristics of the magic tea or hybrid tea or EH plane tea. So it can be asked in any of the forms. So we have here, we have taken two collinear arms, one and two. And here one thing what we have to understand here is the difference arm is taken as arm 3 or E arm. So the E arm is third arm, and H arm is taken as the fourth arm. So if you interchange these things, your metrics will, your equation will change slightly. So those things also we will be discussing further. So we are going to see the characteristics in the next portion. So these things all of you have completed, I hope so. You have completed this figure in the previous class, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we'll see further. Now here we are going to discuss about the characteristics. So in previous classes, we have discussed about the characteristics of E-plane and H-plane tea. So the similar way we are going to see the characteristics of magic tea, where you have a 4x4 matrix. Till now we have been seeing only 3x3 matrix for E and H plane tea. Now we have four cross four matrix, and where you are going to see that the 4x4 matrix for the magic tea, and how the performance evaluation, and what are the basic requirements of magic tea to be clear with. Okay, so you are all able to see the characteristics, no? So all of you are able to see the characteristics. So first we'll start with if two in-phase wave of equal magnitude are fed into port 1 and port 2, the output at port 3 is subtractive. So we have told that third port is a E-plane junction, so it will be subtractive, and hence 0, and total output will appear additive at port 4. So port 4 is H-plane, so it will be additive. So these are the few things which you have to understand. So combination of E and H-plane. So port 3 is E-plane, so it will be subtractive, and port 4 is H-plane, so it will be additive at port 4. Hence, port 3 is called as a difference or E-arm, and port 4 is called as a sum or H-arm. This we have already discussed till now. We also know that since it is having four ports, the matrix representation for magic tea will be a 4x4 matrix, and we have written the matrix as S11, S12, S13, S14, to S1, S21, S22, S23, S24, S31, S32, S33, S34, S41, S42, S43, and S44. So all of you can complete till here. This is quite few things what you already know. Now we have to start finding out the values for each S parameter, like S11, S12, and all those till S44, and substitute in this matrix to find out the S matrix representation for magic tea or hybrid, or you call it as EH plane tea. So that is what we are going to see in this characteristic. So you can all note down till the matrix representation. Then we'll move on further. So all of you write down the S matrix representation for magic T. Then we'll start finding out each parameter S1, 1, 2 and all those things. So we will we have two combinations of E and H plane. So we have both additive as well as subtractive property. So we are going to see that. First we are going to see for E plane T what is that, what we have studied. Same thing we have to apply here as well. But in this case, we are going to have combinations of both together. So since E plane is at port 3, you have S31, S32, S33, S34, everything with respect to E plane. And fourth port is H plane. So you have S41, S42, S43, S44, which is going to be with respect to H plane. So E plane T, it is subtractive. So the first thing what you can write is S32 will be equal to minus S31 since it is subtractive, and also you have seen that it is out of phase. But H plane T is in phase. So you will have a positive symbol, but in the case of E plane T, you will be having S32 will be equal to minus S31. And for H plane T, you will be having S42 will be equal to S41 because it is additive as well as it is in phase. So by using one by one process, we are going to find the values for each positions of this S matrix. So we got two things, like S32 is equal to minus S31 because of E plane T at that point, and S42 is equal to S41 because of H plane T process. E plane T is out of phase and it is subtractive, but H plane T is in phase and additive. So all these things we already discussed in E and H plane T before. So complete it till the matrix. So all of you have completed till step 4.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us continue with step 5. So what you can see here in step 5 is the port 3 and port 4 behaves as an isolated port. So there in the case of that we have taken S33 is equal to 0 and S. So here in this case 3 and 4 behaves as an isolated port, and because of the geometry of the junction, you can take S34 and this S34 and S43. So these two S34 and S43 to be equal to 0 because of behaves as an isolated ports. So 34 and 43 can be taken as 0. And we can also assume that E and H plane T are perfectly matched junctions. So these two values, like we have done before, S33 as well as S44, since it is perfectly matched junctions, that S33 will be taken as 0 as well as S44 will be taken as 0. So this portion is completed. These four things are 0. So we get S34 is equal to S43 is equal to 0 because it behaves as an isolated port, and S33 and S44 will be equal to 0 because E and H plane are perfectly matched to the junction. So now we also know that the symmetric property is applicable for this matrices. Sij is equal to, so we are using that symmetric property and we are going to rearrange this matrix in a different way, like 3, if you have 2, 1, you are going to write it as 1, 2, you are having 3, 1, you are going to write it as 1, 3, and all those things. So using the symmetric property. So by using the symmetric property, matrix S can be represented as S11, S12, S13, S14, S12, S22. Here S23 will be converted to S23 will be converted here. You can see that S23 can be written as S32, and it can also be written as minus of S31. And my S31 can be written as S13. So finally, you can write it as minus S13 here. And then it is S14, S13 minus S13, S14, S14. So, and rest of the portions are zero as we have defined before. So I have also written that why it is so. Since S21 is equal to S12, we have replaced it. S14 is equal to S41 and can also be written as 24, and it can be written as 42. So all these combinations, wherever it is there, you can write it as S14. So S31 is S13. It is also one minus of S23, and this also minus of S32. So anywhere this is there, you can write it as minus S31. Or S minus S13. So also we have S41 is equal to S14 because Sij is equal to Sji. So complete it till here. After that, we have to take matrix S multiplied by its conjugate is equal to matrix U. So that pattern we have to do it and find out the equations and simplify the values for those. Whatever is left out, like S11, S12, S22, all these values we have to find out and substitute in the equation further. So once you complete step 7, just let me know that, then we'll move further. Have you completed step 7?
No, sir.
Okay, complete it and then we'll move further. So any doubts are there, you can just ask me. It's clear that we have, since we have done E plane and H plane, it's one and the similar type of steps. Only thing is that here it is 4 cross 4 matrix, so that small changes you have to understand. Steps are similar.
Finish.
Okay, so we'll proceed with the next process, that is you have to take S multiplied by its conjugate is equal to U. So you can just write this step as you have done for E and H plane T. S multiplied by its conjugate is U. Then you need to take the first row, first column, second row, second column and all. Then you have to write the equations and make it as equation number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So first you write S multiplied by its conjugate is U. So here you need to put star marks. Here I have, you can see here it is missing. You put it as conjugate. here S multiplied by its conjugate. So here you need to put that. So multiplied by its conjugate is unitary matrix. And start writing the equations. So the first row multiplied by first column. So you'll get S11 square, S12 square, S13 square, S14 square is equal to 1. So you put it as equation number 1. Similarly, you write equation number 2, S1 second row multiplied by second column. S12 square, S22 square, S13 square and S14 square is equal to 1. You can write third and fourth equation as well. So all of you have written equation 1 and equation 2?
Yes, sir.
Okay. After that, we'll see equation 3 and 4. So you'll get S13 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. And S14 square plus S14 square is equal to 1. So you get equation 3 and 4. So you can start simplifying it from equation 3. You get S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. From 4, you get S14 is equal to 1 by root 2. Comparing equation 1 and 2, you'll get it as S11 is equal to S22. And substituting equation 5 and equation 6 in equation 1, you can further simplify it and you can see what is the values for 11 and 12. So all of you write down all the four equations 1, 2, 3, 4 and simplify it for the values for 13, S13, S14, S11, S22. S12 and so on. These things are quite simple to solve it. The only thing is that you need to understand the starting few things like it is subtractive, additive, H plane, E plane, combination of E and H plane, then where negative has to be put or where it is zero. So all these things, if you study once, you will get 8 to 10 marks for this question. It is very important magic T. I have told you this is a repeated question in university papers. So it's very easy. You should not miss all these kind of simple questions where you can score better. So you should not leave even a single mark in this type of questions. And they can't twist anything here. They may ask explain hybrid T or they may ask EH plane T or magic T. So you should know that it is the same. So if you can understand that, it is easy scoring 10 marks. So all these things, what you can understand from microwave is it's very easy subject compared to whatever you are studied before. This subject can be scored better antennas portion you need to study little more compared to this first, second and third module. Little derivations may be there, but that is also not complicated. So here we have got the values for S13 as 1 by root 2, S14 as 1 by root 2. And when you simplify it further by substituting equation 5 and 6 in equation 1, you will get it as S11 is equal to S12 and that is equal to 0. And when you substitute here, you know that S11 is equal to S22. So S11 and S22 will become 0 because S11 is equal to 0. So S22 also will become 0. So all the values almost you got it. So now you can just substitute in the matrix form and just write it. So before that, this few theoretical concepts you can just write down. When any two ports of so all of you have completed, I feel. So any two ports of till here you can complete it. When any two ports of four port junction are matched perfectly to the junction, then the remaining two ports are matched to the junction. Such a junction where all the four ports are perfectly matched is called as the magic teeth. So that concept you can just write down there. So all the values are obtained for you in the S matrix. So you can just substitute those values further. This is what the matrix you are going to get. So where you have found all the values and further simplified it, and you will get that matrix S is equal to in this form. So these were the values we obtained. We got all the four equations and we have got S13 is equal to 1 by root 2. S14 is 1 by root 2. S11 is S22. And S11 is S12, that is equal to 0. So S22 will be equal to S11 and that is also equal to 0. So till here we had done, and we want to now convert all these values into the form of matrix. When we wrote the when we have written the matrix, we got the matrix S as a 4x4 matrix, and you can see how this matrix looks like. So you need to substitute all the values whatever you have obtained. So you will get matrix S is equal to, this is the thing, 0, 0. And so this is the matrix S. You will get all these portions as 0. And this portion also will be 0. So rest of the things you are going to see. So you got 0, 0, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, and 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. So you have substituted all the values here and you got this matrices. So one more thing we have seen, that here in this matrix, first matrix, we have taken port 3 as E plane T and port 4 as H plane T in this first matrix. But by if you are interchanging the number like 3 and 4 for the ports, so we will get port 4 as E plane and port 3 as H plane. Then the matrix will slightly change with some symbols here and there. So you will get the second matrix, that is 0, 0, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0. Here it was, here it will be 1 by root 2 and then minus 1 by root 2 will come. Then 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, and 0, 0. So these are the two S matrix representations when the E port and H ports are at port 3 or port 4 or port 4 or port 3. So when they got shifted, you will get in these two forms. So all the matrix representation you got. Most of the cases we use the first one, and if specifically they have mentioned in the problem like port 4 is E plane and port 3 is H plane, then you have to use the second matrix. So you have to read the question carefully and then do that. So this is all about what we have seen in the Magic Tea. We will solve some problems based on that. So you can just note down this first problem. A Magic Tea is terminated by impedance of Z1 is given for you at port 1 and another impedance of Z2 116.67 ohm and at port 2 and some other impedance of Z4 is 150 ohm at port 4. The E arm, so they have told that port 4 is E arm and the H arm is port 3 is connected to 50 ohm. So here you should see that the H arm is port 3. Clearly it is mentioned here. So you have, when you are using the matrix, you have to make sure that which one to use. So is connected to the 50 ohm and power source fed feeding 1 volt of power into it. Determine, now they are asking you to find out the power delivered to the 3 ports 1, 2, and 4 and the power reflected back by the junction which comes out of port 3. So here Z1, Z2 and Z4 is given and they have all clearly told that port 4 is an E arm and port 3 is an H arm. So you have to use the corresponding equation for that. So you can see that the matrix will be 0, 0, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 0, 0. So you can just note down that problem. So here when they have given Z1, so you can find out gamma 1. They have given Z2, you can find out gamma 2. I have told that if the characteristic impedance is not mentioned in the question, you can assume the characteristic impedance as 50 ohm. So here they have not given any characteristic impedance here in the, okay, connected to a 50 ohm, it is given, okay. Here it is given connected to a 50 ohm. So Z0 is given as 50 ohm. If it is not given, still you can assume that Z0 is 50 ohm. So you have Z0, you have Z1. So first thing is that you can find out gamma 1. So you know that ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0 is the general equation for that. So here it is Z1 minus Z0 divided by Z1 plus Z0. You can find out gamma 1, you can find out gamma 2 as well. So you can just substitute the values and do it. Here Z0 is 50 ohm, Z1 is 283.33 and Z2 is 116.67, Z4 is 150 ohm. So you can need to use the equation to find out gamma as ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0. Here in place of ZL, it is Z1 in the question and Z0 is also given to you as 50 ohm. So use 283.33 minus 50 divided by 283.33 plus 50. So you will get 0.7 gamma 1. You need to find out the power delivered to the port 1, 2 and 4. So you need to find out the power delivered and the power reflected back by the junction. So these are the two things you need to find. So first thing is that you need to find out the gamma 1, gamma 2 and all those things. And then we need to proceed further. You have completed that. Z1, you got Z0, you got, you found out gamma 1 and gamma 2. So what is the answer for gamma 2?
0.40001, sir.
0.4, okay. What is gamma 4?
0.5, sir.
0.5. So you have completed till there. So what, now here you can understand what you have to do here. Let you have to take the parameters A and B. So you know that for S parameters, we are going to use A and B. So let A1, A2, A3 and A4 be the normalized input voltage and B1, B2, B3 are the output voltage at port 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have the equation for gamma 1, you can write it as A1 by B1. So which you have studied before. So from that we can write A1 is equal to gamma 1 B1. Just we have already studied that gamma 1 can be written as A1 by B1. From that equation, we can write A1 is equal to gamma 1 B1. And A2 can be written as gamma 2 B2. And A4 can be written as gamma 4 B4. So just substituting the values of gamma 1, gamma 2 and gamma 4, you'll get 0.7 B1, 0.4 B2, 0.5 B4. So here what you have to do here is power is what you have to find out. So input power. So PI. So let us see in the question. So you can see that the power source feeding 1 watt of power into it. So it is very clearly told that 1 watt of power is being fed into it. So that's what we are going to use here. So PI is the input port power, that is A3 square, and that is taken as 1 watt. This is taken from the question itself. So from this we can write A3 as 1 volt, and so you will get this value. So once you get this, you know that the equation for general equation for S parameter is B is equal to matrix S into matrix A. So we are going to use that equation, matrix B is equal to matrix S into matrix A. So you need to use the matrix S of magic T. So matrix S of magic T is already known to you. Where you have to use which matrix, you should see. In the question, it is clearly told which port it is E plane and which port it is H plane. So here, the matrix you will get it as for magic T, it is 0, 0, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 0, 0. And A1, B1, B2, B3, B4, A1, A2, A3, A4. So once you write it, now few things you have already found that A1 can be written as 0.7 B1, A2 can be written as 0.4 B2, and A4 can be written as 0.5 B4. So all these things you can substitute here, and A3 is 1. So that also you can substitute. So you can substitute all the values for A1, A2, A3 and A4 in the matrix. So you just write down these things. Write these four equations we get from here. So B1 is equal to 1 by root 2, 1 plus 0.5 B4. So you can do that. And B2 is this one, B1 by root 2, 1 minus 0.5 B4, and B3 is 1 by root 2, 0.7 B1 plus 0.4 B2, and B4 is 1 by root 2, 0.7 B1 minus 0.4 B2. So you get four equations. Now with these four equations, we need to simplify, and we need to find out the values for B1, B2, B3 and B4. So all the equations are in B1, B2, B3 and B4. So we need to substitute equation 1 and 2 in equation 4 first. So substitute B1 and B2 in equation 4 and find out B4 first, and then you can proceed further. You need to find out the values for B1, B2, B3 and B4. So first step what you can do is substituting equation 1 and 2 in equation 4. So find out the value for B4 you tell me first, and then we will see rest of the B3, B2 and B1. Once you get B4, then it is easy to find out B1 and B2. If you get B1 and B2, then you can find out B3 as well.
Sir, is it 0.2, sir?
Okay, one second. So you got B4 as 0.2 correct, okay? So B4 is 0.2068, right, for four decimal places?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then you can find out by substituting, you need to write for 3 to 4 decimal places because it is all small values. So we get B4, then we can find out B1 and B2. It's good you got that answer. Next, you can find out B1 and B2 by just substituting B4. So find out B1. So it's now simple to solve. When you got B4, just substitute and find out B1. What is the answer for B1? So you can see that you got 0.78.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then do for B2. So you'll get B4, B1, B2, and then you substitute B1 and B2 in equation 3, you get B3 as well. So if you make any mistake in B4, no, all the answers will go wrong.
Sir, B2 0.633.
Yeah, 0.63. Fine. Now you can substitute B3 for B3 and find out B3.
B3 is 0.565, sir.
Okay, 565, let me check. 5654, correct. So you can, after finding out B1, B2, B3 and B4, now we need to use the equation for power and further complete it. So first you need to find out power at port 1. So power output at port 1 is given as P1 is equal to B1 square. So it will be 0.78 square. You'll get the answer. And power output at port 2 is given as B2 square. So you take 0.634 square. So that is what you have to do. And power at port 4, you have to take it as B4 square and do it. But power at port 3, so you can see here. So power at port 3 will be, these all will be power output at port 4, but power at port 3 will be the reflected power. So this will be the reflected power, the others will be output at port 1, port 2 and port 4. This port 3 will be reflected at, power reflected at port 3 will be B3 square, and you can do that. First you complete B1 and P2, then we'll go for P4 and then These are all P1, P2 and P4 is called as the power output at port 1, power output at port 2 and power output at port 4. And the other one is reflected power. So we will see that P3. So get 0.6084 watts and P2 is 0.4401 watts. And all of you have completed till P1, P2?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just complete it if someone has not completed. So you have found out B1, B2, B3, B4 and you got the power output as well. That is what it is asked in the question. Find out the output power at P1, P2 and P4 and the reflected power at P3. So you can complete this by finding out P4 as well as P3. So P4 you'll get it as B4 square and you'll get 0.0427 and the power reflected at port 3 is P3, B3 square and you'll get 0.3196. So whatever it is asked in the question, you have completed. Once you complete it, you can start with the second problem. So a magic T is terminated at collinear ports 1 and 2 and difference port 4 by impedance of reflection coefficients. Gamma 1 is given, gamma 1 is 0.5, gamma 2 is 0.6, gamma 4 is also given for you 0.8 respectively. So gamma is already given here for you respectively. In 1 watt of power is fed at some port 3. So it is already told that which port is 3, some port is 3. So which is that port 3, E plane or H plane? See, when some port is 3, whether it is E plane or H plane, port 3. Which one it is?
H plane.
H plane. So like that you may be given some clue in the question. It is not clearly specified that it is H plane, but they have told that it is some port at port 3. So it is H plane. So port 3 is H plane means you can understand that port 4 is E plane. So calculate the power reflected at port 3, the power transmitted to other 3 ports. So you need to find out the same way the power reflected at port 3 and the power transmitted on to other 3 ports. So we need to, by seeing this, we need to take the S matrix. So since port 3 is a sum arm or H plane, so you can say that S is equal to 0, 0, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1, 0, 0, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 0, 0, and 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2, 0, 0. So you need to study this S matrix for a magic T. If any problems comes, no, you need to directly write this S matrix for, you need to study the S matrix for E plane, H plane, as well as magic T. So in problems, you have to use it directly. So here, you can see that A1, gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 4 is given. So A1, A2, A4 can be found out. What is A3 here? 1, 1. So A3 is also known to you. It's given if 1 watt of power is fed to the port 3. So A3 is also known. So write down this question first and then you can start solving it. It's the same method of the previous problem, so you can try it out. Here gamma is already given for you, so no need to find out that. In the previous one, z was given, so you need to find out gamma. Here gamma is already given, so that steps are eliminated. So you can write down this question and start solving it. So all these values you got, A1 is 0.5, B1, and A2 is 0.6, B2, A4 is 0.8, B4, because gamma 1, gamma 2 and gamma 4 is there in the question, and Pi is A3 square and it is 1 volt, and you can use the equation B is equal to matrix S into matrix A. Substitute the values of A1, A2, A3, A4 and simplify it to find out the values of B1, B2, B3 and B4. You can solve it. You have done already one problem before. You can try solving to find out the values of B1, B2, B3 and B4. So anyone of you have completed the values for that? Let us see the equations to be written. So you will get B1 is equal to 1 by root 2, 1 plus 0.8 B4, and B2 is 1 by root 2, 1 minus 0.8 B4. You will get B3 as 1 by root 2, 0.5 B1 plus 0.6 B2. And the last equation B4 as 1 by root 2, 0.5 B1 plus minus 0.6 B2. So you can see that how to simplify it. So same method you can use, B1 and B2 you can substitute in B4 and find out B4 first, and then you can find out rest of the things. However you want to solve, you can solve, but the answers for B1, B2, B3 will be the same. So you have completed it. Anyone of you got B4? Any of the values we have completed, B4 or B3, anything? B1, B2? So you can take another 1 or 2 minutes and complete it. What is the answer for B4?
-0.0893,
sir. Minus is coming. Okay. -0.0893. Correct. Then find out B1, B2 and B3. So what is B1, B2 and B3? What is B1?
So 0.6566.
Okay, 0.6566. B2?
0.7576.
7576.
B3? 0.55356.
Okay, so you will get B1, B2, B3 and B4. So B4 is -0.0893. Then B1 is 0.6566 and B2 is 0.7576 and B3 is 0.5536 volts. So this is what you are going to get B1, B2, B3 and B4. Now you can simplify and find out power transmitted at port 1. So power transmitted at port 1 is B1 square, and power transmitted at port 2 is B2 square, and power transmitted at port 4 is B4 square, and reflected power at port 3 is B3 square. So if you can complete this problem.